there's also something fishy about the infamous hockey stick graph.
Yes, there is.
The graph shows that after a 1,000-year period of relatively stable temperatures, there was a dramatic spike within the last century, particularly in the last few decades. This is usually attributed to the use of fossil fuels. However, this graph has been shown to be fraudulent.
Yes, yeah, it doesn't record either the medieval warming period or the Little Ice Age from the mid-1300s to about 1885. When we add those back, the graph should look more like this, showing fluctuations in global temperatures before any increase in man-made CO2 emissions.
Well, you know, it's said that a picture is worth 1,000 words. Yes. Well, the image of that fraudulent graph was a fear-mongering tactic that influenced millions of people.
That's right. And the fear it produced motivated people to vote in climate activists.
There's also a lesson from history here, and that's that the world was better off when global temperatures were warmer.
Yes.
In commenting on a TV documentary about global warming, anti-creationist Ian Plimmer said, "Groups like BAMIS and the IPCC deny, minimize, or ignore significant recent climate changes that gave us the Roman warming, the Dark Ages, the medieval warming, and the Little Ice Age. Both history and archaeology show that in previous warmings, temperatures were far higher than at present. Populations and economy thrived.
Nice.
Previous coolings led to famine, depopulation, and social disruption. History shows that it is dangerous to ignore history."
Yes, yeah. So a little warmer is actually a little better.
Better.
Yeah. Okay, so it's clear that there are other goals mixed in with the climate change debate, right? It's not just about saving the planet and following the science. There's outright fraud. Mm.